Hello friends, this is Deupal. So welcome to my another tutorial. So in this tutorial I am going to discuss about how to do RESTful API testing with the help of Apache JMeter. So first of all, Apache JMeter, it's an open source, right? So in order to test any RESTful web service, so either a automation tester or a manual tester, either use one is rest assured for automations testing, and for manual tester they will use that postman, right? Rest client is there, okay. And apart from that, if your project is bounded with the swagger, then you can use that swagger for the testing purpose, manual testings. But as an automations tester, when you need to provide huge load to that particular RESTful API service, so that time you can think Apache JMeter, because Apache JMeter is used mainly for load testings and performance testing. So with the help of Apache JMeter, you can easily test your RESTful web service for load testings and checking the performance. So now let's move on. So what you need? First of all, you need to install that Java. At least JDK 6 or more than higher versions is required. So already I have shown in my different tutorial how to set the path, okay, in Java and how to install that Java. So I'll make you request, if you don't have this knowledge, please go through my how to install Java and set the path this video. You will get the informations, and just you need to check that Java minus versions just for checking whether my Java has been installed or not. Yes, Java has been installed. So why require Java? Because this application's JMeter is fully dependent on Java. That is means purely Java based desktop applications. And now what we need to do? We need to download that Apache JMeter from that Apache JMeter website. So you can see, so this is the Apache JMeter website. Also, I provide this informations in my description sections. You can download that either zip file or tar file from binaries sections. So for the time being, you can download binaries zip file. So if you click this particular link, so automatically this file will be downloaded. So already I have downloaded this file in that particular folder, so you can see. And then what you need to do, you need to just extract this file. If you do extract, so you will see like this type of folder structure will come. So you just need to go bin folder, okay, and from bin folder you just to open that cmd, correct? So if you open cmd, so you need to just type jmeter.bat, okay. You have to run this file. If you run this file, automatically your JMeter should be up. It will take sometimes, but it will up, okay. So this is the procedure how to start your JMeter. So you can see my JMeter is up. So there, this is the approach how to up your JMeter as a GUI, graphical user interface format. But in order to up JMeter, it's a server mode and client mode, so that is a different file name is there, that is jmeter-server.batch file on the same bin folder. And if you want to run in a command line, so you can do so. I'll provide these informations, but main difference from GUI and command line is that GUI takes lots of memory in order to execute, but command line is a very lightweight. And if you want to run JMeter for server mode, because of whenever you need to do distributed testing, so means one JMeter will be act as a server and another JMeter will be act as a GUI in the client computer, okay. So now I will test my RESTful web service, okay. So I am showing, so this is my one RESTful web service. What is the purpose of this service? So purpose of this service, we can add the customer details, we can retrieve the customer details, and also we can update and delete the customer details. You can see, So now we'll run these applications. So already I have these applications ready. So this will act as my server, right? So if you run these applications, you can see. So it will take some times. Okay. And in my applications, I have already Swagger configured. Okay. So that is means I can see the URL. So where we need to hit. Okay. So if you see the log. Okay. So just go down. So you can see my applications has been run on port 8080, right? So if you go to that particular URL, okay, http localhost 8080 swagger hyphen ui dot html, right? So you can see that my swagger file will be open. So this is my swagger implementation, so we can test it from here itself. Okay, so post get delete, but as in our case we will use that jmeter for testing our web service. So now for the time being, if you hit this API, you can see, so this is my URL, so I am using postman. So if you hit, you will get null response because I didn't add any customer details. So let's say I am adding 50 customer details, right? So I have one programs for adding 50 customer details. So now let's run this program. So basically this program will add 50 customers on that particular server. So it will take 2 to 3 seconds to restart the applications. Once it will restart, it will constantly trying to insert this customer data. So we can see that customer data has been populated. So now using postman, I am trying to fetching the customer details. Okay, you can see there is a 50 customer details we can see. Okay, right. So how we'll get the details? If your applications is Swagger configurations, so already you will get that URL. So suppose this is a post, you will get that URL. Okay, so your URL should be http dot your localhost clone your port number then slash customer then slash customer slash customer ID. So this is the URL mapping. So either you can get it from your documentations or your Swagger and from your code itself, but developer definitely will share this information in order to test. So now we will test from jmeter, right? So in order to test, so just right click first of all on that test plan. It seems like my these applications hang. Okay, so just right click and then create a thread group. So you can rename the thread. If you want to increase the number of user, you can increase from here. If you want to increase that time period, so you can increase. So these configurations I'll tell later video. So for the time being, we are making our applications simple. So now add one sampler. So we are going to test HTTP, right? So we'll add that HTTP request. Okay, so this is my configurations. So I am not using any auth or anything. So if there is a auth or anything needs to be done, so you can set in advance. Okay, but for the time being, what is my protocol? HTTP, not HTTPS. So what is IP? So as it is running my local, so this should be local host. If it will run some browser, so some .com or google.com, so this should be your IP or server name and port number. So in my applications, my port is running 8080, so you have to give one. And which method we need to use, either get or post, so we can choose it from here. And what is the path? Okay, we can see in postman our path is this. This is the path. You can see this is my protocol, this is my host name, this is my port and this is my path slash customers. Okay, so now we have done this configurations HTTP request. Now we have to do what? So we have to select again thread group and we have to add some listeners. So this is important. So we have to choose view result is, so we can see this one. Okay, so if you choose this one, and now you have to do that play button. Okay, and before that you have to save that applications. Let's say I am saving this applications like this way. Just you have to hit the play button. So already we have hit that play button. You can see HTTP request. So it's giving these exceptions localhost. Actually I have given wrong name, you can see. So this is wrong name, local. Okay, so that's what it was failed. So now we have to save this file again. Okay, save test plan. Okay, so we have saved, and now again you just play the button. So this is my last one. You can see in my last one this is the sample result. So it's got success, and this is the request, and this is the response data, customer 5b, customer mail. So all this data we have got. So you can see, I mean, this is a pretty simple. With the help of JMeter, we can easily test our RESTful services, and we can check our APIs performance along with load and other parameters. So I think you have little bit understand how we can use that JMeter in order to test for load testings or performance testings. Still, if you have a doubts, just let me know in the comment sections. And all the required informations I'll provide in the descriptions. And one thing I want to convey you, like if you want to test any applications, I mean like hosted in some URL, let's say example these applications. So in order to test this one, so if this is a HTTPS, you have to mention that HTTPS in protocol portions, and this server IP you just to mention this org.api instead of localhost, and port number you don't need to give because there is not any port. And if there is a path is slash API, you have to provide that slash API. And if it is a gate, then you have to use that gate. If it is a post, you have to use that post. And finally, you have to save this, you have to create that listener, you have to save this file, and you have to hit that play button. So if you start, then automatically your test will be executed, and once successfully done, you will see this is comes as a green color, and you can see that response data from that response body. So this is how with the help of JMeter we can test our RESTful web service. Thanks for watching my video. If you like my video, please subscribe my channel and share with your friends, and I'll show you different tutorials related to JMeter in my upcoming videos. Bye till now.